Joe Biden. Stated on September 3, 2019, in an NPR interview. Referring to the Iraq War, immediately, the moment it started, I came out against the war at that moment. Joe Biden falsely claims that he immediately opposed Iraq War. Joe Biden continues to defend his record on the Iraq War as he seeks the Democratic presidential nomination, lately claiming he opposed the war the moment it started. In an NPR interview aired September 3, host Asma Khalid asked Biden to respond to criticism about the Iraq War, particularly sending troops into the country.
"I let my record stand. I think my record has been good. I think the vast majority of the foreign policy community thinks it's been very good. For example, I got a commitment from President Bush he was not going to go to war in Iraq. He looked me in the eye in the Oval Office, he said he needed the vote to be able to get inspectors into Iraq to determine whether or not Saddam Hussein was engaged in dealing with a nuclear program," Biden said. "He got them in, and before we know it, we had a shock and awe. Immediately, the moment it started, I came out against the war at that moment," Biden continued. "Now, the judgment of my trusting the president to keep his word on something like that, that was a mistake. And I apologize for that."
Is it true that Biden immediately came out against the war the moment it started?
No.
Biden's recounting of his position doesn't match the public comments he made right before and after the war started. During that time, Biden acknowledged frustrations with how the United States was heading into war, but said he supported the president. Biden for years stood by his vote for a resolution that paved the way for the war, even though he also criticized the Bush administration's strategy, saying the United States went to war too soon, without enough troops, and without enough countries supporting the effort.
Path to Iraq War.
In 2002, President George W. Bush argued that Iraqi President Saddam Hussein had chemical and biological weapons, sought nuclear weapons, supported terrorism, and threatened peace. In October 2002, then-U.S. Senator Biden voted in favor of a resolution that authorized Bush to enforce all relevant United Nations Security Council resolutions on Iraq and, if needed, to use military force against Iraq. In a Senate floor speech before voting for the resolution, Biden said that failure to overwhelmingly support the resolution was likely to enhance the prospects that war will occur.
"The objective of the resolution was to compel Iraq to destroy its weapons of mass destruction," Biden said. Biden left open the possibility that Hussein might miscalculate and misjudge U.S. resolve.
"In that event," Biden said, "use of military force might be needed, with the support of others, or alone if it came to that.
If it comes to war," Biden said, "the president, I am confident, will go to the American people."
In a speech last week, he made a compelling case that Iraq's failure to disarm is our problem as well as the world's.
"But as I said, he has not yet made the case to the American people that the United States may have to solve this problem alone or with relatively few people, or has he told us of the sacrifices that such a course of action will involve. I am confident that he will do so if and when it proves necessary."
The United States invaded Iraq on March 20, 2003, and the war officially ended in late 2011.
No weapons of mass destruction were found. CNN interviewed Biden on March 19, 2003, as U.S.-led troops pushed closer to the Iraqi border.
Then CNN anchor Judy Woodruff asked Biden if Senate Democratic Minority Leader Tom Daschle had gone over the line by saying that he regretted that one life would be lost because Bush failed at diplomacy.
"No, I think what you saw is a sense of frustration," Biden said, adding that the frustration related to the lost opportunities of maybe being able to do this with others, maybe, if we had others with us, not even having to go to war.
Woodruff also pressed Biden on comments by other Democratic lawmakers who said they supported the troops, but reserved the right to criticize Bush.
"I support the president. I support the troops. We should make no distinction," Biden said. "We should have one voice going out to the whole world that we're together. There's plenty to criticize this president for. Let's get this war done."
Biden also said that at a caucus meeting that day, his suggestion was to send a message that when that first tank crosses that line, we should be on the floor of the United States Senate and every capital in the world hear one voice from both parties, saying, "We support the troops.
We support the president.
And this is the single most important thing we do.
and show it by our actions.
Le who, the her.
Protecting Life, the Department of Health and Human Services has published a draft of a new strategic plan that states in its introduction that life begins at conception. The personhood of the unborn child is central to the abortion debate, as even the justice who wrote the landmark Roe v. Wade opinion has acknowledged, because, if established in law, it would nullify a right to abortion. The largely overlooked HHS Strategic Plan for 2018-22 states the agency accomplishes its mission through programs and initiatives that cover a wide spectrum of activities, serving and protecting Americans at every stage of life, beginning at conception.